Well, hi, everybody, and welcome to Moodle Support Theater version 2.5 here at HSU. We have landed on the main page, and you're looking at probably the most requested feature we've ever had. Lots and lots and lots of people said, please, let's land on our courses instead of the site page. And there it is. You're seeing whatever courses you are enrolled in, you should be seeing them in this center column area. Now, in the navigation block on the left-hand column at the top, this thing, I have collapsed it. If you notice by clicking My Courses, it can get a little bit long, but if you're teaching several classes, this thing's going to get big in a hurry, and you're going to lose that administration block all the way down at the bottom of the page. So I recommend in navigation, where you see the word navigation, there are two small boxes. The inside will hide the navigation block. Let's click that. And the outside, or right hand, will dock the navigation block. Give it a click. And there it is on the left-hand side of the screen, sticking out like a tab. Now, if you float your mouse over it, you can still see all of the items that you need to use and utilize them. Or right under the navigation tab is a very small box. Click it, and it undocks. So you have a lot of choices and configure this the way you want to. I'm going to open my navigation block by clicking the inside on the plus. Where you used to land is now called Site Home. Give it a click. And here you have the Moodle announcements, office hours, special things going on that we do hope you're going to take advantage of. To get back to where you were, come to the navigation block and choose My Home. Clicking My Home will take you back to the page you saw initially. Right-hand column, we will have latest news, things that are going out in the forum. Please check those out. It's things like when Moodle will be offline for scheduled maintenance, things like that. And right under latest news, we have marking. If this is something that appeals to you, a new and kind of interesting grading option, please make a point to visit our grades and gradebook series. We'll go into complete detail on that. Right now, let's go to the center column. Let's choose Video Base 1 and go into the class. Here again in the left-hand column is an example. That navigation has gotten pretty big. I'm going to use the inside block and just make it a little bit shorter. Settings is now administration. That is directly below navigation. And as we look at the things in settings, you will notice that edit settings, the hand holding the pencil has been replaced by that little gearbox. Not much of a change because it still says edit settings. I am going to click edit settings because there's something very cool I want to show you. We have the course name at the top, long name and short name. That is still not editable, but making this course visible is no longer two-thirds of the way down the page. Now it's right here at the top. Once you've got your class ready for students, use the show hide option in the drop-down and make this class visible. Also, if you scroll down a little bit, you're going to see that everything has a little choice next to it. For example, if you want to work with the course format, give it a click, changing it from, for example, weeks to topics, things like that. We have new choices in appearance. If you click appearance, we've doubled the number of themes you may choose from last semester. We had a lot of requests for that, and we have doubled the number of themes. There are also two built-in themes for tablets and for phones, which are going to make access much, much easier. Here's the key point. Let's come back up to the top. Let's come all the way over to the upper right-hand corner, and there it says Expand All. And we scroll down, and we see this looks just like it used to. A lot of people said, why do I have to do all that scrolling? Well, you don't. You can choose Collapse All. I generally choose General and Description, and that's about all I'm going to need until I scroll down and choose Files and Uploads, Appearance. Once you get pretty confident with this, you can just say, well, I want to change my appearance and I want to change how many files they can upload, and take it from there. As always, save changes at the bottom, and it'll be that way when you come back. Okay, we're going to look around the page some more when we come back. If you need help between now and then, stop into Moodle and Library 315. Remember, these training videos are for an introductory purpose and not meant to take the place of getting some assistance or coming to one of our workshops. We will come to you. You can come to us, or we can work through TeamViewer on the internet. We look forward to seeing you. Our extension is 3633, and we've got a lot more videos to come. Thank you.